Hey, stargazers, welcome back. My name is Nick. I'm a theaters manager at the Adler Planetarium, and you're watching Skywatch Wednesday. Well, this episode, we've got all sorts of excitement about the moon, from planetary pairings to a lunar eclipse. We're setting our sights on our nearest neighbor. Well, the fun begins tonight at sunset. Right after sunset, you've got a chance to see the thin, very thin crescent moon and the planet Venus at their closest for the year. They'll be only about 1 degree apart. That's about 2 moon widths. It'll be a beautiful sight in the twilight glow, with the moon barely a day past the new phase and brilliant Venus sparkling nearby. They'll be quite low, and they set within an hour of sunset. So, just like the pairing of Mercury and the Pleiades that we highlighted last episode, a clear sky and a clear view of the western horizon is a must for this sighting, so choose your spot accordingly. The next night, May 13th, the moon will have moved eastward in the sky, a little higher over the horizon at sunset, and it'll be near Mercury in the sky. This pairing isn't nearly as close as the one with Venus, and Mercury is much dimmer, but the pair will fit in the field of view of binoculars. And because they'll appear in a darker sky later after sunset, you should get a good view of what's called Earthshine, sunlight reflecting off the Earth and shining onto the moon. You'll not only see the thin crescent shape, but the rest of the moon will be faintly illuminated, giving a striking three-dimensional appearance. Just 2 days later, the moon will be visiting a third planet in the sky, our old friend Mars. Mars is the dimmest of these three planets right now, but also up much later in the evening, so this sighting will be less reliant on good fortune of a clear horizon at sunset. This is a great opportunity to see the moon's slow movement as it orbits the Earth. It will slowly be drawing nearer to the red planet in our sky here in Chicago, and as it sets just before midnight, it will appear noticeably closer to Mars than when the night began. For viewers farther west, the moon and Mars will appear at their closest, about 1 moon width apart, just after 11 p.m. Pacific time. The moon completes the first quarter of its orbit around Earth on Wednesday, May 19th. That night, look for the half-lit moon in the constellation of Leo the Lion, just about 5 degrees from the bright star Regulus. For the next week, it makes its way across the constellations of Virgo and Libra. And on the night of May 25th into the morning of May 26th, the big, bright, full moon will be shining just on the border of Libra and Scorpius. May's full moon is known as the Flower Moon, and this one will be extra special as it undergoes a lunar eclipse. What you'll see of this eclipse depends a lot on where you are on Earth. For those of you on the east coast of the U.S., hardly anything will be noticeable as the moon sets at sunrise on the 26th, barely having entered the outermost part of Earth's shadow. For observers in Chicago and much of the Midwest, the moon will set when it's about halfway covered by the darkest part of Earth's shadow. It'll certainly be eye-catching and a very interesting chance to see this astronomical alignment as the partially eclipsed moon sets in the west just as the sun rises in the east. For observers farther west in the U.S., you've got a chance to see a totally eclipsed moon in the early morning hours. And the best and most convenient view is going to be saved for those in New Zealand and eastern Australia, as the entire eclipse will be visible on the evening of the 26th, with still enough time to get a good night's sleep after it ends. So what's going on during a lunar eclipse? Well, there are three types of lunar eclipses: total, partial, and penumbral. With total lunar eclipses, the moon fully enters the darkest part of Earth's shadow, the umbra, turning deep orange or red as the red sunlight passes through Earth's atmosphere and shines on the moon. Chicago and most of the U.S. last saw a total lunar eclipse in January of 2019. The next visible total lunar eclipse for the majority of the U.S. will be in May of next year. We're not quite as well placed for this particular eclipse, but it should still be an interesting view. Partial lunar eclipses occur when the moon only partially enters the darkest part of Earth's shadow. In this case, you can see the curved shadow of Earth lying across the moon. This is what viewers in the Midwest will see on the morning of the 26th, but the moon will set before becoming fully eclipsed. Sometimes, though, a partial eclipse occurs without a total eclipse being visible from anywhere on Earth. That will be the case later this year in November. Occasionally, a very faint eclipse occurs called a penumbral eclipse. Even in a dark sky, this type of eclipse is barely noticeable, with only a slight darkening of the moon. The moon only enters the outer part of Earth's shadow, called the penumbra. A string of four of these types of eclipses occurred last year, with very little fanfare, but thankfully we have a good stretch right now of more eye-catching lunar eclipses this year and next. For more on this upcoming lunar eclipse, be sure to check out Adler's Sky Observers Hangout that'll be live on Adler's YouTube channel Tuesday, May 25th at 7 p.m. One more item of interest before the month closes out will be a close pairing of Mercury and Venus after sunset on the 28th. Mercury has been making a good appearance this month, and that continues even as it gets lower and dimmer. During its plunge toward the horizon after sunset, it will have one last hurrah. On the evening of May 28th, Mercury and Venus will appear within a half degree of each other in the sky. Now, as always, a clear sky and a clear view to the west will be important, but you should have no issue spotting Venus, which is currently shining 300 times brighter than Mercury. Although they appear very close in the sky, they're actually on completely different sides of the solar system right now, and only appear close from our vantage point here on Earth. Mercury is at the end of its evening appearance this time around, but Venus is just getting started on an evening apparition that will last all the way through the end of 2021. Well, that's what we have for you this episode. Thanks, as always, for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to Adler's YouTube channel and also follow us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and TikTok. Happy stargazing, and we'll see you next time.